Welcome to a standard video of playing the deck called Tibalt's Trickery. Woo! This is a deck that gets a lot of talk lately. I have been playing this deck for a while and also wrote a deck guide on CFB Pro. This video will try to show you a little bit how the deck performs on Magic Arena. For those of you who are new to it, this is an instant spell that basically works as a polymorph, where you counter your own spell, normally a zero, and you will hopefully dodge the other zero or the Tibalt's Trickery, and then you'll be able to get for free one of these large, large threats into play. That's the best case scenario. Worst case scenario is just that you flip one of these zero or Tibalt's Trickery and you get stone nothing, or you just mulligan to Oblivion, because the only way you can get, you know, the God Hand or stuff like that is via mulliganing. Basically, cantrips are dead in Magic since the London Mulligan, and the only cantrips we are playing here is, in fact, the Mulligan. One of the most important deck decisions is, in fact, the mulliganing. So today we're trying to get through that I'll just get through that decision as much as we can. The rest of the deck also acts like a ramp deck. You can easily cast your cards. You have the Wolf Tree that will help you out, cast Genesis Ultimatum and Dream Trawler, as well as Ezika to ease you out that way. The sideboard is pretty self-explanatory, or rather, it's not, but I'll get to it very quickly. It has the B plan of a ramp deck, adding three lands up to 27, the land counter, and I'm going to sideboard this way against the control deck. Anola is for the mirror match. Again, pretty straightforward deck, but let's get into the game to see how this deck performs on the ladder. So far, I haven't had the best result, but I tend to play best of three. This deck definitely performs better in best of one, but I do like to give a, competitive view of Magic rather than just best of one, which of course it is Magic, but it's definitely not competitive as there isn't any, you know, PTQ or stuff like that in that format. And let's go, we're getting into the games against OQB. Let's see how it is gonna go. This video is also live on my Twitch channel, twitch.tv/AndreaMengucci. I'm live every morning, European time, and I usually draft and play standard. All right, I'm gonna keep this camera over here for the mulligan decisions, then we're gonna move it on the side for the gameplay. Opponent goes first, I'm gonna choose to mulligan this end as it is missing the land and the O's. And we're gonna go down to 5 pretty quickly here. What about this end? All right, so this end is down to 5. It has the colors, it has the O's, but it's missing Tibalt's Trickery. I believe that this end cannot do it. We have to go down to 4 cards. Going down to 4 cards means that we see 7 new cards. We have to hit, you know, a couple of them plus 2 lands. So I think we have better shot at just getting a new 7. Remember, we have 8 O's and 4 Tibalt's Trickery here. I think I have to stop on 4. We have 1 temple to look for that Tibalt's Trickery, and that will be enough here. Gonna bottom the Ugin Spirit Dragon, the Ezika God of the Tree, and the land. What if we instead keep the Ezika? We could keep the Ezika over a land. I actually prefer this way, I think. Yeah. It's gonna be very tough here. We have to draw exactly the Tibalt's Trickery. You don't necessarily need to hit it on turn 1, because... Sorry, on turn 2, because you're still playing like standard. If you do like a good hit by turn 3 or 4, it's gonna be okay in some matchups. When it's playing Boros, looks like... Ooh, a Robber of the Rich. Please don't take Mighty Ball's Trickery. Actually, they didn't, because I have way less cards than them. Alright, I'll pass here. I can't cast this Stone Coil to block. I need to keep it for the O, as an O. Alright, go to 16 here. At least our mulligan to 4 made so that the Robber of the Rich isn't really working, right? Okay. The fail rate is obviously pretty large, and you're seeing it here in the actual first game. Okay. Pretty brutal, because also my opponent is just passing the turn back. I can just play this as a 4-4. Is that like a winning line? I think like now I think I'll, I have to just like just hit next turn. They're gonna go like stomp end of turn. I go to 9, attack me down to 4, and then like even if I have a 4/4, I think I can't really win a game of Magic with just a 4/4 here with this hand card, with this kind of end. Alright, do I get the 2-boss trickery? I don't, and I'm going to concede the game. Alright. Not the best performance, but you know, the fail rate of this deck, it's definitely high. Yeah, again, the sideboard only happens, sideboard plan, change of plan only happens against a control deck. So we're gonna run this back for game number 2, where I'll be able to play against Mono Red. Basically, whenever you submit this deck, you have to be ready for, you know, the very high fail rate of this deck. And it's also, you know, one of the reasons why this deck isn't... It has the potential to be broken. Of course, I haven't shown it to you yet. This is just the first game. But, could be. Alright, I'm gonna keep this. I'm gonna play. And we do have the combo, so this is a keep. The combo again is to cast this whole priority, counter it, and just, you know, hope to reveal. To reveal good enough. When it's playing mono red, there's just very few ways a mono red deck can deal with what we're trying to do here. I'll bottom that land. I don't need it. Perfect champion. Javier Dominguez himself over there. Alright. I'll just play Tormod's Crypt now because it is obviously just more dead than Stalker Serpent. Alright, let's see if we flip something good here. It's turn 2. We mill the Nugin and we flip T'Boz Trickery. Man. Alright. And we pass the turn. T'Boz Trickery unfortunately does have not only a fail rate in your mulligan, but also in your... okay, what about World Tree? I'm gonna keep this World Tree on, because I could cast this Dream Crawler eventually. I'll hold the Stomp Cold Serpent. I'd rather it to be a 3-3 so that I can play around Stomp. Alright, so that's a Shadows Go Smashing. And I'm just going to play Rimrock Knight to pump it. Alright. Do I want to play a 3-3 Stone Cold Serpent? Because I could also wait on it for be a 4-4. I think I will go for the 3-3 here and just block this Fervid Champion. They could also just have another Fervid Champion, maybe, and that will be good enough. Do I want to go for the World Tree? So if I cast the World Tree now, it's not going to do much, because I don't have that many green cards. I'm just going to scry. I guess I should have scryed first now. Not a Dream Trawler. While this is not bad, I'm looking for the 6th land, ideally untapped, so that we can go World Tree next turn and then turn after Dream Trawler. Remember, this card says, as long as you control 6 or more lands, your lands add any mana. So, that is good here. If we... Alright. Opponent's attacking me. I can't block this. Or, I mean, I can, but I'd rather just kill the champion there, right? Maybe not. Actually, I will, yeah. Well, yeah, because this one creates 2 Seder right now if it dies. So I'd rather it to just create 1 next turn, since it's a 3 next turn. Draw a Z-Cam. I can cast that one, and I will pass the turn back. Now, again, if I top deck an untapped land next turn, I can play Dream Trawler, and that could be good enough against Mono Red. Ooh, the Akron War. Ay-yi-yi. Sure, how much damage is this? I go down to 3, draw, the boss trickery, okay. It's not the end of the world here. I can cast the Tormod's Crypt, and I can try and counter that one. I can find a Nugin off the top now, let's see what we find. I find a Planar Bridge. Unfortunately, Planar Bridge here doesn't do anything. Sorry, Prismatic Bridge, so I have to concede the game. Alright. I'll floss in the first round. I'll be back for the second match. Okay. Ugin can deal with the snake, but we would have killed the Akron War, and the snake would have come back to us. All right, that's a first defeat. Let's be back for round number two of the Stubal Trickery deck. So you saw, you know, basically you saw in this match the two worst case scenario. One of the first one is where you just mulligan to oblivion and never get the combo. And the second one is when you do get the combo, but unfortunately it's not good enough because it definitely has, it's not like a consistent combo. It's not like, I don't know, Shuentel Omniscience Emrakul. All right, let's go play first. I'm inclined to keep hands like this. I'm in the dark. I do have Tibalt's Trickery. You might feel like this is a three cards hand, but it does have a temple. I'm only missing one of the O's. I think I'm keeping these kind of hands. The most important, the most difficult card to find in this deck is Tibalt's Trickery. It is definitely not the zeros. All right, looks like I'm in the mono red bracket here. We did find the zero. Although, word trick, I'm suitably tapped. So next turn, we'll go ahead and do the thing. Our opponent attacks us for 4, down to 15. We get Rimrock Knight. Okay, good. I'm on 13. A whole full control again. You cast Serpent, pay X equals 0, confirm 0, and then you Tibalt's Trickery it. Yes. Alright, what do we flip? We flip a Planar Bridge. Prismatic Bridge. That's not too good. That's not too good. That might be slow and it might not be fast enough. I'm hoping to flip next turn from the top of my deck a good creature. Oh, that's another for a champion. That's an amazing start from my opponent who puts me on 7 life already on turn 3. Okay. Find another Ezekiel off the top. Wow. Someone could say that, you know, this card isn't good enough as a hit off the Tibalt Trickery. And that is definitely, something, you know, if you just don't play this card, you just play mono threats, it's better. All right, here I just died to this Castle Imbaret, so there's just very little I can do about this. Okay, we lost again. Impressive. I'll be on the play for game number two, and again, I'm moving the configuration, and we'll see. So far, I don't have the best win rates. You can check it on exclamation mark untapped on my stream right now. It is 10-9, 10 wins, 9 losses in best of 3. But it's definitely like a new deck and one that's worth showing. Nothing particularly strong. As you can see, the fail rate is very, very, very high. But that's okay. It's just you know, good for some. It's actually, you might think it's quick games, but it's not that quick. Like, often, if you get paired against a slow decks, you do get to like the hard cast territory very often, especially post sideboard. All right, I'm on the play against mono red. This is not a keep, especially since it's on 7. Okay, I'm keeping this one. I'm only needing, all right, keep 6. I'm only needing one land for the combo to happen. And, you know, of course, that is just, it's much more likely. Basically, whenever you keep, like, hands that don't have all the pieces, by all the pieces, I mean two lands, Tibalt's Trickery, Tormos Crypt, or Stone Cold Serpent, is that it's much more likely to just draw one of the missing pieces sometimes than to mulligan for a new configuration. All right, one is attacking me. Okay, I hold full control. Play this and that. Yes, summon me one, a two. Resolve. Alright, we flip the top card, and again it's this thing here. Oof. Okay, though now we have the True Temple of Abandon, so we can scry. Let me just read this card quickly again. I believe this just shuffles it, right? At the beginning you have reveal cards from the top until you reveal a creature, put the rest on the bottom. So I'm gonna bottom this land here, and I'll pass. Let's see what we flip off this bridge. Hopefully it's not a Stone Cold Serpent or an Ezekiel. Okay, let's see what we flip off of that. We flip a Stone Cold Serpent. That is indeed a fail. And I'll pass it back. Man. Could still like find an Ugin or Dream Trawler. If they have Ember Cleave, how much damage is this? 6 plus 3, 9. So I'm still alive here. And the problem of that here is that if I find an Ember Cleave, an Ugin, I have to kill my own bridge. What happens there? All right, that's a Dream Trawler. And I'll pass it back. See what happens now with this Dream Trawler. Frosty Bee. So Frosty Bee deals 3 damage to this Dream Trawler. I have to let it go. I can't tap it. They have 3 cards left. This is not a burn spell. It is indeed. And I am defeated. Alright, good game. So far we are 0-4 in games, which isn't impressive at all. But I'm hoping to turn it around at least in the next 2 match. Again, you just don't have to see this as just bad variants, because I also made the choice of putting Ezekiel to my deck. You could just not have Ezekiel to your deck and only have good thing and just have the, you know, Harkas plan just gone. Although I do believe that I won several games with this deck just via Harkasing. Or opponents playing Kiruga the Macrosage as their companion. You don't see that very often these days. Alright, my hand is perfect. Hold priority, serpent for 0, confirm 0, debuff its trickery, auto pay, resolve. Sometimes you just get Ugin and they just brazen borrow it too. That's not a fail. Alright, you get ultimatum, which is the best hit off of debuff trickery. It's the best hit of debuff trickery, not only because you can, it's just the best hit because you're also very easily able to hardcast your cards. Now that I ramped, you know, you just often like ramp like 2 or 3 times. But yeah, I've also had a situation where I debuff trickery into Ugin and I was playing against the deck with Brazen Borrow, which my opponent very likely has, and they just bounced the Ugin, and I just felt very stupid there. But it is what it is. Okay, I have nothing to do here. I'm just passing, hoping they don't interact with my Ugin and I can emblem it. -10 it, and then I can just put all this expensive stuff into play. Alright, looks like they passed. Very good. Now it should be all gone here. Allora, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Submit 7. Spratatrak. Alright. That was a good game, they say. So, against control, I do like to have counters, but my opponent is playing a weird deck, right? They're playing this Kiruga the Macrosage deck. Huh. Maybe they just take out Kiruga and just like boarding counter magic. game 2, like they bring like Negate and this Deathstroke and they don't reveal our companion anymore. So what I'll be doing here is go for my plan. So against control deck, I like to go for the ramping plan, giving up on Buzz Trickery. Thank you, Rick Benz, for the 100 cheers. The Tormod script and the Ugin's. Ugin's, as I said, is very bad. My opponent 100% played Brazen Barber, and I just don't want to have Ugin around. I guess now I switched plan, so, you know, still, like, Ugin is just not a good card, I believe. Yeah, Emerge Ultimatum is definitely a way to build in your deck. The reason why I dislike it is that it makes you put into the deck Vorinclex, which isn't a very good card, and it makes you put into your deck Valky, which again is not, like, I think, an amazing hit. Everything is better than the Planar... No, I don't think so, actually. Tibalt is probably better than the Planar Bridge, but I don't think... I think Vorinclex is not a good hit, basically. That's why I'm not playing the Ultimatum plan. Our opponent goes first. Well, Mulligan. Remember, we boarded out our combo now, so we are a ramp deck. Let's see how that will pan out. To keep. I have to bottom a card here. I currently don't have green, but that is not a big deal, I think. Well, we'll find it, hopefully. Okay, we find a Zika. I'm looking for a green source. Let's see if I find it. I don't, so I'm gonna bottom this. On the play, I do like to keep the combo because they can't interact with me with the negates or stuff like that. Opponent did keep in the Karuga. So they... Wow, imagine scrying on Magic Arena. This was my last Rugged Triumph, by the way. And so opponent kept in the Karuga, meaning that they don't have negate or Disdainful Stroke or Miscast or stuff like that. But it certainly will have Mystical Dispute, I'm pretty sure. I'm just going to go Cultivate here. That will use my mana more profitably. I'll get Forest and I'll get Island. And I'll put it Forest into. And they passed. Nice. I will go ahead and play the Cobra here, which will let me play. Actually, I'm able to play Dream Trawler regardless. All right, I'm going to go Cobra here. I think I'm going to hold this Azika, actually. Yeah, I think I will hold on Azika here. Because I can cast Azika thanks to the... So I'm missing two colors to play the Planar Bridge. The Prismatic Bridge. Because I'm missing on black. Actually, I don't miss two colors. I have... let me just think a little bit. I have white, blue, red, black, and this one gives me black. So I'm all set here, right? I'm all set. I'm just gonna go Rogrin Triome. Yeah, because like even if they kill my Cobra, I'm okay. Yeah. We did go for the ramp plan and it is working. I mean, my opponent could have had a counter there. I don't know actually. Because they do have Kiruga in their deck. I'm not exactly sure what's going on there. Polish Dynamite. Thank you, Polish Dynamite, for the 10th month. Welcome to the stream. All right, let's attack for two first. And then I'll play a Temple, and I'll play Dream Trawler here. I'll keep this on top. Yeah, that feels like it's a good card to leave on top there. Thank you, Gira. 24 months. That's a 2-year anniversary. Thank you so much, Gira1, for the renowned support. Alright, so they do have the Dispute. Next turn, I will be able to play the Planar Bridge around Mystical Dispute here. You did get the Taralucci badge. Look at those Taralucci badge, Gira1. Thank you. Opponent keeps on not doing much. I'm very happy I went for the B plan here. Okay, so here I will be going red, green, white, blue. And then I can play an untap land at black with a Cobra. Then I can play the Prismatic Bridge. And I can play around Mystical Dispute here. They have Negate. Oh, they can't have Negate again. They can Karuga the Macrosage. They can have Saw It Coming. Okay, yeah. Sure, Just have to pass it back. Ooh, Aka. My opponent is leaving two mana up. That you know, they do a Karuga, but they have a card in the four tail zone, so it can be a Exoic coming. I have one land left in my deck. I will just go for land first, and then Dream Trawler. Again, playing around Mystical Dispute. I can't play around the foretold Soid Coming, unfortunately. Yeah, that resolves. I will just finish the turn with a Lotus Cobra with a Cultivate. Picking up... Oh, actually, I have no land left. So I must have drawn the last one. All right, I'll pass the turn. Wish I kept that in my hand now, because it would have been all right in case I draw another Dream Trawler. This is some water. ASMR. Now return the Aka to hand and this Cry 2 card. Up bottom, okay? My opponent has played so many counters this game. Again, if we had gone off on turn 2 and like revealed not a blue card, it would have been good. Ooh. Oh yeah. Just keep on playing this land first to play around those Mystical Dispute. Let's see if they have another Soid coming in the Foretell zone. And they do! That's the third one. Ay, ay, ay. Okay. Keep on attacking and pass. When I can play Alruun the Ear at the beginning of... Okay. So this is a very large creature because they have lots of cards in end. Come on, draw a good card. No. Okay. Oh, Chance Ultimatum, nice. And I'll pass the turn. Okay, so I'm hoping they don't have the fourth Soid coming, or I don't know if the deck plays out of counters. This is just an 8-8, right? Let me just read it again. At the beginning of your end step, choose a card. Yeah, I think I'm taking an 8 here, right? Because the Chance Ultimatum, a Cobra is good with the Ultimatum, as I get to land into play, get mana, and then I can just... pick up a card and I can cast it with the ultimatum mana. The revealed Raven form. Oh, the revealed island. Okay. Not sure what happened here. Oh, the top two cards. I see. Okay. Yeah, let's play ultimatum. They can't dispute this. Let's see if they have another counter magic to this. I have one Ugin left only. Because I boarded three out. I have Stoneclaw Serpent, which isn't very good right now, but I can just... keep it in my hand. Sublime Epiphany. All right, I'll surrender to the Sublime Epiphany. I'll surrender to the Sublime Epiphany. Let's go to game three, where I'll go back to my original plan of just be a fast combo deck. Ugin is just bad, though, right? I mean, I just don't have a sideboard. I guess I can have more lands. I can keep more lands than Ugin. Maybe a couple of lands I can keep. Something like, yeah, just so that I don't have to mulligan because they don't find, lands. I think Ugin is just, I guess though, like the more hits you have, the less you break off of the more hits you have, the more Ugins you have, the less you can break if you cast the Ball Trickery. So I'm going to actually submit this one. All right. The Anul are for the mirror match, so yeah, I've never played it. Okay, I'll play first. This is a mulligan because I'm looking for a two ball trickery, fast combo here. We've seen how many counters my opponent's playing. I'm going down to five. Now we're just basically mulliganing to find the combo only. There it is. Keep five. I'll bottom the spells. I'll keep the lands just in case we fail. We might just start our casting. I'll just go with this. I don't really want to scry, do I? There's nothing really I'm looking for. I'm hoping they don't go island. If they go island, they could have Mystical Dispute. And if I flip a blue card, they can dispute it. Dispute is actually very good in this matchup. Alright, let's see what happens here. I could break revealing Stonko Serpent or Tibalt Shriekery. I don't. I find an ultimatum. Do they have the dispute? They don't! But I flipped so bad! Look at this! Man! Man, 3 Azika, come on! Yeah, this is unfortunately put them into play, so you can't put the other side of it. We do have a Stone Cold Serpent, meaning that if we draw another Trickery, we can restart, but my opponent is indeed playing the control deck over there. Attacking with my Zika for one. So I drew the World Tree, which is not bad. It means that on 6 mana, I can start casting this ones. I think I'm going for Temple here. I'm looking to draw the 6th and tap land here. Very glad I played a Skyland. I think I will go for the Stone Cold. My opponent might have trouble dealing with just like pressure. I do have the 5 different colors because I have black here. So next turn I'll be able to go Planar Bridge, Prismatic Bridge. They do have 3 mana now. Very glad that I added Rugged Triumph to the deck, because our casting Dream Trawler and Prismatic Bridge is definitely a real thing, as you can see in these games. Oh wow, they tap out for a Midnight Clock. You don't see that very often. I'm attacking for 5 here, and then I'll play the one and only Prismatic Bridge. Opponent can dispute this. They don't. Again, Mystical Dispute is a very real card against this deck, because most of the threats are in fuck blue. So Dispute on turn 1 is very effective. It's one of the out of fail rates of this deck. It's also Mystical Dispute, despite your combo is like red. Okay, Brazen Bard there, that's fine. I'm very glad I didn't flip an Ugin off of the Trickery now. Also, one of the reasons why I was kind of boarding out all the Ugins. So my War Tree still doesn't add rainbow mana, because it's only 5 lands, but thanks to Azika and the Rogren Triome, my Chimera deck was able to Arcast the Prismatic Bridge side. Okay, they just got back Karuga, wow. It's definitely interesting. Alright, now I think I'm gonna cast a Dream Trawler rather than... Oh, I can't cast Dream Trawler, actually, because I have green, red. Unfortunately, there was no way for me to do that. All right, I guess I'm just casting again this Planar Prismatic Bridge then. And I'll pass the turn. I have not tried Chromatic Warrior right now. Yeah, it could be a good idea. Just that against the fast decks, maybe it's not very effective, especially if you like mulligan down to very few cards. You want to have something impactful. Not saying that this Prismatic Bridge is impactful against the aggro decks, but it is definitely a card that's like helping me out here, you know, because I just cast it in, etc. Why do I want Raven Form of this guy? Sure. Okay, I found Tibalt Trickery. Interesting. Now, what I can do is also just go for that. Like, I cast the Zika and I counter it. What if instead I just again cast this Prismatic Bridge? I think it's just more effective. If they have a dispute, it would have been bad, but I hadn't had a dispute in a while. So, yeah. Ooh, Icebreaking Kraken. Sure, so what happens here? My creature's Daunt and tap. 8-8. Return 3 is no lands, return to your hand. And reveal the Spirit Dragon. Alright, what do I do with the Spirit Dragon here? I can... I have a few lines. Opponent's on 7, which isn't much. I don't want to go minus 3. I think I will go just pink face and then I'll go for Ezika Tibau Trickery. Because I do the pink first because in case I flip another Ugin, I can ping again. So I'm gonna hold full control. I'll play Ezika. And I counter it. Thank you, Big Boss. 26 month. Thank you so much for the subscription. A lot of months of support. All right, let's see what we flip now. There's a lot of bad hits here. There's a Tormos Crypt, Stone Cold Serpent, Tibau Trickery, another Ugin. Your favorite form Malera went off? Hello, LSV. Good morning. Or good night. All right, let's ping them to face. Looks like we're going to win this first match. And it is good. I don't want to say too loud because, you know, things... This deck is fun to watch. All right. Okay, so Karuga, I would draw the two cards. Sure. And explode. Yes. I won a match. Woo! All right. Let's win some more now. Let's win some more matches now. The ramp match almost went... Thank you, Rick Benz. The ramp match almost got there. Almost got there. This was a game where we just went Jens Ultimatum on turn two and we were almost about to lose. That's funny. What was the opponent playing? They were playing Mono Blue Control based off of Garuga. We are in the Platinum ranks of Magic Arena, so it's not that we're playing against top tier decks, but it is good. It is Magic the Gathering after all. Lately, I'm just getting into old school a lot, and that's just real, like, you just play with what you have. You don't necessarily play with what your streamer of choice told you to play, which is a refreshing feeling in Magic the Gathering. All right, I'm gonna mulligan this hand. Oh, we got it. Nice. Keep. What's worst? I think the comma is slightly worse. Thank you, Arbassa Sea God. Temple. Probably just keeping a land on top if I find one. Sure. Wall tree. That's okay. Our opponent. You know, Dondu. Duress turn one. It is game one of best of three, so... Alright. So I'm gonna hold full control. Play... Island. Play Stone Cold Serpent for zero. Play Tibau Trickery. Alright. One time. Dobrik. We have 7 bad hits of Tormos Crypt and Tibau Trickery and 23-24 good hits. Nice. It's a Jens Ultimatum off the top on turn 2 of the game. And they're tapped out. So. Okay. We didn't get very good, but it doesn't matter, you know? It's still, like, solid. It's still, like, solid. That's one of the things with this deck. You don't necessarily have to, like, hit great. You can just also just play past the turn here. It's still turn 2 of the game, so we ramped 3 mana and drew 2 cards. It's still very good. There are 3 islands, because remember, when you cast Ultimatum, you can't choose the backside of these cards. They just come into play as they are. Yeah, so I'm passing the turn. Next turn, what I can do is very funny. I can cast World Tree, and then I can cast the Planar Bridge immediately. The Prismatic Bridge. Sorry, I keep on calling Planar Bridge. I hope you guys can forgive me here. But yeah. Remember, World Tree is also not legendary, so you can play, you have multiple in play together. Very, very good card, World Tree. I'm very happy to have it in my deck. So you see, this is why we play Ezika, because it's pretty... I don't want to say it's pretty easy to arcast because it's obviously did it and it's not easy. We needed a lot of setup, but we've arcasted this card very often, whereas you just don't really arcast the rest. And you can just flip an Ugin. Like, obviously here we're getting, like, the good variants of the Prismatic Bridge, but... it's legendary, I'm assuming? Yeah. All right, that's a good game. Playing against Gruul. We don't change anything, and I'm just gonna run this deck back. So you've seen the first two game matches, we bricked off very, very hard, and now we got a good variance. This is what's called a variance deck, a very high variance deck. So whenever you play against this deck, you'll feel very bad, and you want them to ban the opponent deck when it hits good, and you're like, you know, not so, it's fine if it doesn't. Exactly. It seems very unfair when it works, and it feels like, what am I doing when it doesn't work? It's what it is. It's good that I started the video with just losing a lot, so that, you know, all the haters are gone already. People that keep watching videos usually, you know, the haters don't have a long tolerance. Like, they don't, the haters don't really, like, watch a thing for more than, what, like, 10 minutes? What's the threshold for a hater? Alright, I'm going to mulligan this end, it's missing, like, everything. I think I'll go to 5 here. We only have one temple, so I have, like, so few draws, like, three or four draws before probably just dying. So, I prefer just opening a new 7. Okay, this is a keep. This is a keep. I'm 100% sure that this is a keep. We have the Tibalt Trigger, we have two temples. Keep 5. Return two cards. Uno. I can return Ezika. Or I can return a Wall Tree. Ezika could block. I'm against Gruul, so maybe a 1-4 is like good enough to block on turn 3. I'm gonna keep this end. Forest. Jewelling Keeper. No. Okay. Yeah, let's see if I can find a 0. Land is like not the worst because let me cast this on turn 3, but that's not what I want to do on turn 3. I want to play at the boss Freaker on turn 3. Alright. We have 8 good hits here to draw, and then, you know, once we draw that part, we have to also hit well with the boss Freakery. Your opponent, if they have Fable Passage, that's a lot of damage. Alright, thankfully they don't. It is just 7 damage. You go to 11 on turn 3. Let's see if I draw a 0. 0! It's not a 0 at all. Oy, oy, oy. Oy, oy, oy. Yeah, Alberto, I'm still recording. I will record until I switch to draft. I get a 4. Do I die to Emberclava? Alright, that's it. I could have countered it, I guess, but if I countered that, there's not much a game to play. So yeah, you can go off on turn 3, but you're flipping against Gruul, you might die on turn 4 pretty just easily. They didn't even do too much. All right, on the play for game number 3, let's see how it goes. Opponent name is Viper. First, let's go mulligan. No, can't keep this one. Let's go to 5. Nothing. Go down to 4. Okay, I'll keep this one. Keep a bottom on 2, 3. Do we find an O's on the top? Nope. But we can do it. We can do it. Oof. That was a colorless card. I almost thought it was an O, but it is an 8. I mean, 8 and O's are kind of similar if you look at them. Like, without glasses, maybe. O's? Nope. No O's for Mangu. Thankfully, though, my opponent isn't doing much over there. They are not killing me on turn 4 this time around. It's 2 O's. That's a good point. Alright, the Edgewilling Keeper will resolve. Wow, they braked on land? Huh? Ah. fine. It's not that bad here. What do I want to do with this one? I think I'm gonna get a forest. And yeah, your turn. I mean, if I draw like three lands in a row, I'll just cast Coma into Ugin if they're breaking. Oh, they found a red source. Scary. Scary. Not gonna counter that one. Of course, I go to 14. Do we find an O? Oh. I could die to an Emberclade. No, they don't have double red. I am in Timberclaw, in World Tree territory, so any land will make me play Coma. Even if it's blue, of course, any untapped land. The Unleashed. Okay. That's 8 damage, I go to 6. Alright. Top deck. Oh, not close enough. Alright, that's a good game. We have been defeated. Gonna play a last match for these recording, which will go on the YouTube channel of Channel Fireball. And then we will switch the draft on these streaming day. If you haven't heard the news, don't follow me on Twitter. Tonight, I'll be playing on stream against Javier Dominguez Old School. We will be doing the Old School Clash again. I have done it last week with Matt Sperling. I have bought a new webcam from Amazon so that my face won't look like in the 90s anymore. But yeah, tonight, 8 p.m. European time zone, which means in basically like 10 hours-ish, I will be playing against Javier on this channel. And then the recording will definitely go on my YouTube channel as well. All right, play first. That's Mulligan. Okay, so I remember keeping a hand like this. I remember keeping a hand like this once. I'm playing as Lurrus the Dream Den, which means probably Rogue, which means that I can never win. No, I'm not saying that, but Rogues is definitely a tough matchup. I have to Mulligan here. I can't just hope to draw back-to-back land. If I was against, like, maybe like a Gruul deck, maybe I could have kept. I don't know, actually. Let's just Mulligan this one. Let's go down to 4. Yeah. I changed the webcam though. Now it's gonna be a brand new webcam. And alright, so I'm going Mulliganing down to 4 here. Okay, and that's a keep. Then the deck I will play is a blue-red aggro burn deck with Flagman. It's gonna be cool. Still waiting on a few. I'm still waiting on few cards to arrive to take the deck pick. Ooh, sweet. The second to bot trickery. I'll put it as a discard spell. I can, I'm gonna play around it. Oh, 2 swamps. Oh, that is not blue black rogue, thank god. Oves? Mice. I go to 18. And we just get back Lurrus. All right. So now there's an interesting situation where I am able to cast Tibalt Trickery in my opponent's turn, and then counter my own Tibalt Trickery. As a result, I'll be able to flip off the top. Of course, you have more hits now, since you have all the bad hits. Actually, no, it's the same. It's so similar. You have 10 bad hits instead of 7. Similar. Alright, so they're doing that. I'm gonna hold full control here, and I will go Tibalt Trickery on the Fulmar Knight. Submit 1. Pay 2, and then I will T-Boss Trickery, the T-Boss Trickery. Yes. Auto pay. Resolve. And let's see what happens. We're flipping Coma. Nice. That's why Mulligan into T-Boss Trickery is much, much better than Mulligan into the zeros. Because you can also just draw Tibalt's Trickery in that case. Alright, so we got Serpent. This thing has Death Touch. I don't want to trade a Serpent with this, right? Huh. Maybe I do. No, I don't. I'm just passing it back. Do I want to sacrifice things to tap them down? No. This thing can get indestructible, so do I want to trade this for that? No, I don't think so. I'll just pass it back. Alright. They did Blizzard Brawl, so they want to make this... that's an interesting choice by the opponent. I'm gonna make this indestructible. Also, one of the reasons why I didn't want to trade Full Marinade for Coma for Serpent is because they might just have a... Oh, okay, this thing doesn't fight. I feel like my opponent is playing a Death Edge fight spell. They don't play Fraction Obliterator, though. They do not have Fraction Obliterator in their deck. Inscription of Ruins. I discard two cards. Do I want to attack with one Serpent next turn? I don't think so. I don't want to lose any Serpent. And I am not in a rush. When it is attacking, that's an interesting choice. Why would they do that? They're both indestructible. Okay, let's cry. I'm looking for... You know what? I don't mind the land here. Do I mind the land? I don't mind the land here. That will be the 6th land for the Wall Tree, and then, like, I'm about to cast almost every spell I want. It will want to attack here. No, it's fine. They have Lurrus. I don't want them to just get value for free. They don't have much to cast off of Lurrus yet. Have Bovida. I don't think Coma will be hit on Magic Online Cube, no. It doesn't... I don't think it's a very good threat in the... You know, comparing to other Vintage Cube threats. I did make a list of cards that will go to the Vintage Cube, though. And one of them is Ezika. I think Ezika's cool. Alright, but again, Deadweight, Coma. I mean, it's not the worst Deadweight in Coma, I guess. Yeah, that's fine. Unfortunately, Coma does not get X-proof. They only get indestructible. And he can tap permanent, which is relevant at times, but not now. They can't have Obliterator? Of course they can't. We're playing standard. Alright, so actually they're killing my Lurrus. My Coma there. Look at that. Results. Yeah, they have triple Deadweight. Wow, that's impressive. Goodbye, Coma. Okay, I want 16, so I can't take a bit of hits there. I'll play the 6th land. Yeah, I'll play the 6th land. So that now the World Tree is online. I could draw Planar Bridge, I could draw Dream Trawler, and I would cast them all here. We went to approach the... Ooh, wow, the tech with Lures. They must have, like... something like another Malachi Rebirth, maybe. I'm definitely blocking Lurrus. I don't want to block these because they have Death Edge. And if they're Lurrus, or oh, maybe they have like just a reanimation spell, Gleam's Awakening, or Call of the Death Dweller. Call of the Death Dweller, okay. Okay, that's a 7th land for now. A good hit is Coma and the Ultimatum, as well as Kyurabes the Sea God. So that's a lot of good cards that I could cast here. Although I did mill most of these. I don't exactly remember how. Oh, they made me discard these cards. Yeah, that would have been amazing. They made me discard these cards, and I would have been casting them here. Seeing as Menace right now. I'm taking 6. I don't think there's much reason to block a March Rider right now. I can block it maybe next turn. I will cycle this one here. I could find the Stone Cold Serpent maybe. I'm happy with the Dream Trawler, kind of hoping they don't make me discard it. But outside of that, pretty happy with it. Because actually, Lurrus has Death It, right? Mm. So still interesting here. See what happens. They deadweight that thing. Not sure I agree with this play, but sure. Because they're now not able to flashback Mark Trident. Okay, so I'm taking 4. I go down to 3 life. I should have that on board. With this Dream Trawler, so I have to top deck something else. Top deck Ezika. Unfortunately, none of these matter, right? I guess they might make a mistake and attack me with a full Mart Knight. So I'll play Dreamy T thanks to the World Tree, but I'm dead on board to the Lurrus attack. Yeah, the art casting plan part of the deck is definitely real, and I can go they dead weight and that thing, I'll let it go. That's a 1/4, that's a 1/3. Still dead to Lurrus if they attack only with Lurrus. Attack with both, so I'm not dead. Okay, that's good. I can now top deck and stay alive. What am I looking for? Genesis Ultimatum is the card I'm looking for the most. But here I go to 1 life because of the lifelink. Alright, Genesis Ultimatum, please. That's a good start. Okay, let's keep on calling the cards now. I'm calling Ugin for sure. What else do we call for? We call for Ugin, I called for Koma, and I call for Kiora, Best the Sea God. These 3 cards, thanks. I need all these 3 cards. I find none. Oh, what's so no, I lost. Even a land would have been helped me out here. Even a land would have helped me out, because I could have cast a Stone Cold 1/1. Man, what a bummer. Huh. What a bummer. I'm hoping they don't attack. I mean, they missed lethal last turn. They might miss lethal again. This thing has Menace indeed. This is such a roller coaster of emotion. This deck. Alright, don't attack. No, they saw the line. They saw the line. Alright, good game, opponent. Good game. Let's go to game 2 where I won't be changing the card. 1 land would have saved me. 1 land would have saved me there. Alright, yeah, let's go. Yeah, exactly. 1 land would have been enough. Well, I mean, I guess it had to be untapped. But it's so cool. Like, Magic the Gathering is such a cool game. Like, opponent had the lethal line, didn't see it, and then drew the only card maybe that was, like, good enough for me to keep me alive. But it wasn't. It ended up not being one. So, yeah. Such a great roller coaster of emotions. The Lures had Menace, so I was not able to single block it. Vivian with the Nicol Bolas art. I used to have the Nicol Bolas art, but now I'm just on Munya Ling for life. Maybe you can see it with this thing, but I am on Munya Ling for life. Probably like one of the only cards that I don't own in paper. Like, I don't have that many cards that I don't. There's not that many cards in paper that I don't own. But Munya Ling, I don't have one. All right, game number 2 against Green Black Obliterator, but without Obliterator. Let's call it Obliteratorless. Alright, play first. That's a great hand to Mulligan. It will follow it up with another Mulligan. Then down to 4. 3 cards. I'll stop on 3. We have very few outs to win the game, but it is what it is. Alright. On this duress, I think it is time to concede, explode, and greet you all. Thank you so much for watching.